Right, g'day guys, back again. This time we're going to show you how to break down a deer, which I have done on other videos before, and but also after that we'll go down to breaking it down to the muscle groups and cutting it up into steak as well. So it's all good shooting your animal, but being a hunter, one part of it is, I reckon anyway, is being able to cut up your own meat and process it yourself, and it's all organic meat straight from the field to the freezer basically. So knowing how to cut up the meat yourself rather than take it to the butcher is a handy little trick to know as well, and it'll save a little bit of money in the long run. So I'm no butcher by any means, but I've cut up a few deer in my time. My father taught me originally, and then I've had mates that have been butchers who showed me little bits and pieces, so I've picked up little bits and pieces on the way. But you can take whatever you like from this. This is the way I do it. So you might learn something, it might help you out, it might not, but here we go. So first of all, we cut round through here. You can see the line around by the leg. Just be careful you don't go right round to the back steak. I clear, I guess it's called the belly or the flank or something like that. The butcher will tell you the right terms. You can see the line down here. So you just follow that line to about there, to the hip, and that'll expose your eye fillets. Give that to Blakey. And this is your eye fillets in here. Oh, bit of TB there, that should be right. So eye fillets here, I just cut straight down the backbone there, and always go from the backbone outwards. So you just sort of scoop your knife around, down and out, down and out, down and out. Like so. Once you get to there, should be able to give it a bit of a pull. It goes right up into there like that. So there's one eye fillet out. Looks like a bit of a mess, but it's actually got a bit of a film over it, so you can just actually grab that, pull that, give that to the dog, and there's a nice little eye fillet there. Alright, so that's one eye fillet out. The other eye fillet's just the same, just straight down the spine like that. Start at the bottom and just follow those ribs out. So you're just following that out like so, straight up there, right up, and just give it a bit of a pull, and like that. Oops. So that cleaned itself up as well. That's a nice little eye fillet. Blake really wants to eat it. And that's just waste. So once you've got your eye fillets out, so you can basically see where the back leg stops there, there's almost a line there. So you just go straight around there to the spine. You can go both sides at the same time, but you only need to do one at a time. Poke your knife in there and just follow that spine in, angling your knife, so this is exaggerated, but angle your knife into the bone like that, so you're not going to cut accidentally into your back steak. So you're angling your knife down there and just following that all the way down, and then trying to get the right angle for the camera, I'll go around this side. So I always start at the top like this and just find that first rib. Whoops. And just always, again, going from the backbone out until you hit this first rib, just there. And then some people don't take this flat meat off, but there's actually quite a bit of meat in there, and it's good for sausages and mince and stuff like that as well, so it'd be silly not to take it. And it's really easy to take. You just got to cut around that rib, so just follow that line around basically. And you got the brisket there, so just cut straight at the brisket, following that down. Same again, angling your knife into the bone. And you can get real fussy and take those little bits of meat out of between the ribs if you wanted to, but I wouldn't worry about that. But they do make those little bits of meat between the ribs make really nice jerky. So you sort of got to there, you've cleared those ribs out a little bit, you've got that flap off there. The back steak's still hanging there, so we come back to the back steak. and just follow that around again. And having a long boning knife like this is good because you can just use the end of it and you just go around. So I take all this off at once, and then once we get all this inside, we'll break it down into the different muscle groups and take the back steak out and all that sort of stuff. I'll go right up the neck on this little fellow. There's not much neck meat in there, but so basically you're left with one side, your back steak's attached to that, so if you want to get that back steak out, you can just grab it and pull it out, but we'll leave that attached for now. Poke a hole through here between the bone and the meat, and I've got a hook over there. Poke the hook through there, and we'll hang that up there while we do the other side. So now we've got to here, we've basically boned out the front half of the animal. So we want to separate the rib cage and that from the carcass. So you basically follow a line from where you cut around from the back there, and you'll find a big join, which is right there. So basically just cut your knife straight to the little join, go one way, the other way, and see how that's separated there. And then just grab the neck, lift that up, and that'll just break off. And we'll give it to the overgrown Labrador Hunterway, and he'll eat that. That'll be his feed for the next week or so. So now we're to the back legs. So these gimbals here are really good to use because you can actually unhook one leg and leave that leg hooked on, and it'll stay really well hooked on, really well hooked on. So with the back legs, just clean this up a little bit. There's a little bit of udder in there. It was a nice little wiener hind. It was actually not a very big animal. So get to there. So just cut in a straight line, straight between the legs, straight down to the bone. You feel that separate and heard that, and you can actually, it opens them up a bit too. So like if you shoot a big stag in the middle of summer, ideally you want to slice that right through like that and let it cool down. On these smaller animals you won't need to worry too much, but they can go off overnight with the heat they hold on there, especially if they've got heaps of fat, because the fat is like an insulator and that'll hold all the heat in. So if you shoot a big animal in the middle of summer, you're better off to whip the skin off it and slice it down the middle, open it all right up so it can get the air in there, or chuck it in the chiller, of course. Even in the chiller though, it'll still hold the heat. So so we've got the backbone running down here, and there's another little bone up here. So basically, I'm going to follow the bone around like this, and follow this up this way till I hit that bone. So I've hit that bone there, and I'll go around that bone like so, and then just following with my knife. So not fighting with it, you're just putting your knife in there nice and just following that, following the contour of the bone edge around there. So you've done that, come back to the front. There's already a slice there, so I go straight down here. There's a join here, so just cut through that join, pulling down on that leg at the same time. Cut through here, and be careful not to cut straight through and cut your rump off. So cut through here, you've got the bone here. So we just cut down like this, through there, and then that's one lovely little back leg that's going to be quite delicious to eat. So we'll hang that up there. So the second one is back on here. So same thing again, exactly the same thing again. So if you get a bit confused on what you're doing, you can't stuff it up too bad. All you're going to do is leave a little bit more meat on the bone. So the best way to do this is just to give it a crack. So cut that around there like that. Same as the other side. Grab onto this. I like to put a bit of weight on this when you're doing it, and just cut through here again. You find that big join in there again. So we go, we've already gone through the join, and then just angling your knife down on that bone like that. and that's what they call the H bone or the wishbone or the hip bone. So that's breaking your deer down. So now we'll take the deer inside and we'll break it down into the muscle groups and take it off the bone as well, and then we'll show you how to trim off the silver side and get some really nice steaks out of it. So to get the back steaks out of the front shoulders and stuff, you can just grab it and pull it out like so, and these are nice wee back steaks. So we'll come to that later and I'll show you how to trim off that silver side off there, which will give you a lovely better eating steak without the chewy silver bits and that on there. Right, so now we've taken the back steak off the front shoulder. I generally don't muck around too much with these front shoulders, but you can get a roast out of it, or otherwise you can cut it up into little chunks for stir fries and that, but I generally just bone it out and I'll get that done into mince and sausages. As the clients that have been hunting with me will know where their mince and sausages come from, it's all the front shoulders and that of the deer we shoot. So we flip it over to the outside, so the outside's facing out, and you'll feel the shoulder, the edge of the shoulder blade coming down here. So if I open that cut up that I've just done, so basically what you want to do, you've got the big join up here, poke your knife in up there and then just follow that down, and same on this side, poke your knife in there and follow that down like that. Butchers are probably shaking their head saying, oh, that's the wrong way at the moment, but hey, this is the way I do it and it works for me. So once you've done those two cuts like that, just put your knife in here and just sort of fillet it like a fish sort of thing, and that, and just follow it up from the bottom. And this will take out your shoulder blade. So you come up to about there, like that. So that opens that up. And then same on this side here. So just watching your fingers. And just don't cut into the bone. If you're cutting into bone, you're never going to cut through bone with your knife. You're just going to blunten your knife. So if it's not cutting, just stop, have a think about it, move your knife up or down or whatever, and start again. So once you've opened that up, open the shoulder blade up, use quite a long knife. And I poke it underneath, angling your knife up towards the bone like so. So not flat, it's angling it up into the bone. So I'm poking it through, angling it up to the bone, and then just a bit like a fish again, filleting that off. So you're getting most of that meat off the back of that. And then just follow that down to there. You'll see the socket in here, the join. So once you get to there, you stop. And I just grab this here and go, pop that up like that, and that pops that shoulder blade out, and you can see there's not much meat on there, there's only a little bit there I've left on, but it's pretty clean. Throw that to the sink for the dog, and now you've got your main bone in here. So I just basically stick my knife in here and follow my nose, so you just see where the bone is running down here. We're going to leave the shanks on these because they are beautiful eating, so we're not going to throw those away. Lots of people do. So just follow your bone around, basically, like that. And down. And you can see where it's joined on there, to where it goes into your shank. So you just cut through here. Done. So that's, I would... You can get steak out of that if you want to, but or stir fry or whatever you want to do with that, but generally I don't muck around too much with it. I just get it done into sausages and mince, and it makes really good sausages and mince as well. So I'll cut that up into cubes like so, okay. Cut those up into cubes in these big sinewy bits like that in there. Just cut those out because they'll be chewy. Dog will like those though. And any shot up bits, like I say, this one was shot in the head, so there's no damaged bits, but you've got these big glands in here as well. The lymph nodes, I think it is. You can cut those out too. They're probably not that great at eating. Chuck those out. And then there you're left. So that's one front shoulder off a small deer, and then you've got your shank as well. So if I was going to cook that with the bone on, I'd just cut that straight through there with the handsaw. And then you've got that nice shank off the other three legs as well, so you'll have a decent feed for probably three people there off those shanks. So, but I've actually been cooking the shanks. I can fit more meat in my crock pot if I actually bone them off the bone. So I'm going to bone these off the bone. So same thing again, just cut through the top there. Just follow that around. That's one side, same here. So you've got that big tendon there, so I sort of stuck back off here a bit. Go around there. Just following the bone is all you're doing. And that'll keep all that good meat on there. And that's your shanks, which is doesn't look like a hell of a lot there, but once you've got another three of those together, it's chuck it in the crock pot, she's a good little feed. So we'll chuck that there with the pile, rest of the pile. That there's for the dog, so there's not a hell of a lot of meat left on there. So we just repeat the process on the other front shoulder, exactly the same way. So we'll just pretend that we've done that one and we'll skip straight to a back leg. So back leg, trim off all the shot up stuff, all the dried up bits of meat, so you can actually trim some of that stuff off. The more time you spend trimming your meat up, the better the end result's going to be and the nicer it's going to be to eat. So if you spend a little bit of time trimming off some of the shit, the end product is going to be a lot better. Alright, so now flip this over. So we're going from the inside of the leg. You can see the big bone in here, and you can almost see this line running up here. So we want to follow that line basically. So I'll start in there and just follow that around, and that's straight down onto the bone, and then follow that around here and down there, and you can see the bone is starting to be exposed in here now. And same on this side, just open that up. Around in there. So same thing with the shanks on these, you've got that big tendon running down there, so I cut that off there, cut through here, I cut right round. Following the bone around here again, got a big bit up here, just comes back around to there. That will do, just all peel off nicely. Like I say, I'm not no butcher, but this is the way I've done it and it seems to work, and you can pick up whatever you like off this, so it might be helpful, it might not be, but this is just the way I do it. So you might be able to use something from this to do the way you do your deer, and then it might help maybe. So there's the bone there, that's not going to waste either, that's going to the dog. So we've taken the skin off this animal, we've taken all the bones. The only thing that's gone to waste on this animal is the guts, basically. The heart and the liver got eaten, and this is all your nice back leg meat. So on the end of this here, you've got your shank meat, which is roughly around through there. So that's your shank meat, we'll cut that over here. So separating your muscle groups, this is your back leg, so you can actually use your finger and follow that through. Here's those big glands I was telling you about, so you can actually get those glands out because you don't want to eat those really. So there's one muscle group there. Same again, just you can use your thumb to separate this, and can see the joint in there. So just poke your knife in there, around there, and that's one piece. And then you get this dry, especially if you've been hanging them without the skin on, they get a bit of a dry skin on the outside of the meat, so you can actually just peel that off or just trim it off with your knife. Peel that off like that. Okay, so that's your back leg separated into its different muscle groups there. So we've got the silver side, top side, rump, and knuckle. There's probably all sorts of different names for them. And also we've got the shank meat there as well, off the two shanks as well. So what I'll do now is I'll bone out these other two legs, and then we'll come back to trimming that silver side off and trimming it up really nice.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness till boredom overtook us. And he began to speak. He said, "Son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice." So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, "If you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play."
Right, so the next step from there, we've boned it all out and we've broken it down into the muscle groups. So the next step from there is that we're going to cut it up into our steaks. I like to steak my back steaks. Some people like to leave them whole and cook them whole like that, especially on these little ones. They're really good. Sear them, roll them in your herbs and seasoning in that first, sear it, and then wrap it up in a bit of tin foil and chuck it on the barbecue for 5-10 minutes, especially a little one like this. All done. Yep, so I like to, especially on a little back steak like this, I like to do little medallions, and I'll show you how to do those, which is butterfly steaking it as well. So that bit there isn't actually back steak, that's just a bit of rubbish meat that can go to the mincing machine. So there's two ways of taking the silver skin off the back of a back steak. So my preferred way I like to do it is putting your back steak like this, and you can see where the silver side is. Just poking your knife under there, not right, you know, keeping it as close as you can to that side, poking it under there, and then just coming back this way, angling your knife upwards. And that'll get it started, and then you just flip it over like a fish. Flip that over like that, hang on to this bit. Put your knife in here and angle your knife, not on a huge angle down to the board, but on a slight angle, say a 45 degree angle to the board. And then just sort of working it slowly and pulling on this bit at the same time. And pulling it through as you're gnawing away. Done.
Oh, bloody Sean's just turned up, yes. Eh? He must have smelt the venison from his place.
A little bit too early by the looks of it.
So, that was just taken off the silver side, so that got most of it off, and it comes up really nice, and then you can just trim these other little bits off, and it will come up absolutely divine. How do you do yours, Sean? Do you like to do yours whole? Or do you cut them into little medallions?
I cut them into little
medallions as well.
Yeah, sometimes I'll butterfly them, so I'll go halfway through and then cut the next one right through, flip it over and get a bit of a pattern.
Yep, that's exactly how I like to do them as well. So I'll go like halfway through there and then full way through there, and you can actually open them up.
Yep.
And it makes your steak, especially on those little ones, gives you a bit more of a steak. So you go through there. I like to do my steaks reasonably thin, as you can see. Everyone's got their own different opinion on how fat you should have your steaks, but personally, I think venison, you should cook it on a real hot pan and nice and fast. So if it's thin like this, you're not going to overcook it, and it won't go, shouldn't go chewy, especially on a nice young one. So that's what you call a butterfly steak. So if you only went through there, you'd only have a little medallion, which is not too bad. But go halfway through or three quarters of the way through and then right through. Fold it open.
tender.
Okay. Right, so the next step, or the different ways of taking off the silver side off your back steak, is some people like to do it this way. So they slice through the back steak, but not all the way through, like this. And then the same thing as before, just grabbing it like a fish and just filleting that off like that. And that will leave you a beautifully filleted back steak with no chewy silver side. So you got that side there, and you can just grab that, pull that off. That's all your chewy, horrible stuff. Throw that in there for the dog, and you've got this nice silver side left. These bits here you can just trim up. And there's a little bit of silver there as well. So the more you spend on preparing your meat there, the better your end product's going to be and the tastier it's going to be. So we just repeat the same process with these ones. We just butterfly steak these, so 3/4 of the way through, right through, 3/4 of the way through, right through. And I like to make my steaks about a centimetre thick. I think if you make them any thicker, they take too long to cook and you won't get the full potential of the venison flavour out of them. Because you cook these with butter in a searing hot pan with a little bit of garlic, salt and pepper. Searing hot, so it's smoking before you put them on the pan. Put them on there, 30 seconds, flip them over, another 30 seconds and that's done. It seems like they're not done, but they are done and they'll be delicious. Best way to eat venison is rare. That over the pile of our back steak.
Just eat it.
Mm-hmm. Raw venison is also good for you, but you got to make sure it hasn't got any TB. Yuck, I wouldn't eat it raw. Unless you're really hungry. Right, so, still got that bit there to do. Eye fillets. Now, lots of people reckon these are the cream of the venison, and good on you. But I personally think, this is just my personal preference, they're actually quite strong, and I'd actually rather have the shanks or the back steaks over an eye fillet, to be honest with you. But basically with the eye fillets is you can do the same thing. So there's quite a little bit of silver side on there, so same thing again, just poke your knife in there down and try and get that off. It'll be a bit harder on this because it's not so dominant, I suppose, the silver side on this, but that got it off just a little bit like that. And you can just cook those whole, put them into some herbs and spices, and then just sear it on all four sides and then just slice it up and eat it, and it'll be absolutely beautiful. Right, so that was the back steaks, sliced and diced and taken the silver side off them. Now we've come to the rump. Like I say before, this wasn't a very big animal, so the rump is not much of a rump, but you're still going to get some nice steaks out of it. So with the rump, basically a steak knife is always a lot better to use as well, but I haven't got one, so I'm just making do with what I've got. So just slicing through there, that first bit could probably just go straight into the sausages. So now we're moving on to the top side. I find you get some quite good steaks out of the top side, especially on the venison. But there is a little membrane on here I like to take off first, which is sort of like a outer skin on these deer. So you can see there's a bit of a skin on there. So I'll just take that off. Otherwise, when you steak it, it just gives you another layer to your steak, and your steak isn't a nice solid steak. It sort of falls apart in bits and pieces. So I'll take that top layer off there, like that, and that's not going to waste either. That'll go into the sausage meat, into there, and then now you're left with this nice piece of meat. So you can see down here, there's a seam down there So I'll actually cut that seam right through. Some people will probably just leave it joined on and cut it all as one. I actually cut that off, and then you're left with this nice bit here, which is bloody nice steak. So I just cut the end off it. That can go to the sausages again, and then same again, about a centimetre thick steaks. Well, there's some nice steaks there. Butterfly those steaks if you wanted to, but personally I don't even muck around with that. I just take the best of the best. It's not going to waste because it's going to sausages and mince, but I'll just take the best steak for myself, so I know it's going to be really good. And then you still, off a small animal, you still get a reasonable amount of mince and sausages out of it too. So same thing again, just so we'll chuck them. So now we've got the knuckle. You can use this for schnitzel or off these smaller animals. I actually don't mind roasting these. Chuck them into a roasting bag with a few herbs and spices and a bit of onion and roast them. Sear them first, of course. Throw them in the oven bag and then roast them for probably half an hour, and they'll be done on about 200. But you can also just slice them and make schnitzel out of them, so make it nice real thin slices, and have venison schnitzel, which is a nice wee treat. So now we've come to the silver side. So same thing with the silver side. Why they call it the silver side is because it's got a silver side on it, which makes sense really, doesn't it? So we want to take that silver side off though, because that's going to be, that'll shrink up once you throw it into the frying pan. That'll shrink up and go chewy and horrible. So we'll just trim that off as best as we can to Clayton standards. So there you have it guys, that's boning out and staking up your kill. So if you're a hunter, it's one thing that you should know. It's all good going shooting them, but it's another thing actually cutting them up and processing them to eat for you and your whānau. And there's nothing better than actually eating something that you've gone out, carried out of the bush, and cut up yourself and cooked it for your family. But that's how you bone your venison out. We've got the best of the best steaks here. We've got your back steak there. We've got your top side there. And we've got the silver side there, and your top side there. I put the knuckle into the sausages, and all the other stuff has gone straight into the sausage bag here, which is probably 7 or 8 kilos worth of sausages and mince there. And we've got the shanks there as well. Awesome. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm heading off on a hunt this weekend. We've got 4 guys at our Red Deer block, so there's going to be another video coming up from that as well. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.